Welcome, everybody. Join us live from Mustang Stadium, class of 2022 graduation ceremony. By 7 o'clock, we should get things started. Here you can see the commencement program on your screen. The processional will be led by Mr. Josh Dargavel, our music director. And we will see the graduates coming through the arches here shortly.
Thank you.
just a few minutes before 7 p.m., where we'll get started with the 44th annual graduation ceremony for Hidden Valley High School, the class of 2022. Our archbearers for the evening are getting ready. Our junior class arch holders, Gia Bentz, Natalie Sandine, Morgan Tiffin, Callie Vidlak, Megan Wasink, Madison Williams, Ashley Yunker, Grant Bohannon, Caleb Christian, Ryan Diotti, Frankie Hatley, Kale Samandi, Aiden Kanat, and Kyle Staten. Archbearers are getting ready for the graduates to make their way through, and we're about to begin. Thanks for joining us. Thank you.
Good evening. At this time, if you could take a look to the west. At this time, we ask you to rise and remove your caps if possible, as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem. Welcome and good evening. Gosh, it is not only amazing to see this many people in one place, it is great to see smiling faces. Can we take a moment to give ourselves a huge round of applause for this wonderful evening and this event? My name is Damian Croson, and I am the proud principal of Hidden Valley High School. On behalf of the students, staff, and administration, I extend a heartfelt welcome to the friends and family of our graduates. Tonight, we are honored to have you here to witness this momentous occasion, and in true spirit of Mustang Nation, the graduating class of 2022 requests that you silence your cell phones and please honor them with enthusiasm as they are called to receive their diplomas. Please keep your cheers somewhat brief, as we want all families to hear the names of their graduates. Thank you for your continued support and commitment that makes Hidden Valley High School the premier high school in Southern Oregon. The graduates would like to take a moment and thank a few people for making tonight possible. Tonight, we thank the Three Rivers School Board members: Jennifer Johnston, Board Chair; Paul Kelly, Vice Chair; Rich Halstead; Jen Searle; and Susan Fisher Mackey. Please give them a huge round of applause. Tonight, we also thank Superintendent Dave Valenzuela, Deputy Superintendent Casey Alderson, Special Ed Director Stephanie Allen Hart, Elementary Curriculum Director Jessica Durant, and Technology, Foods, and Transportation Rob Saunders. Please give them a huge round of applause. Lastly, we thank the entire Mustang staff and the families of our graduates for your countless hours of love, dedication, and support. Your efforts are greatly appreciated, and without you and the everlasting memories that you've helped create, graduating from this high school tonight could not be possible. So please, graduates, give your families a huge round of applause. Can we also give a round of applause for Ciro Bignotti and Southern Oregon Audio, Susie Biller, Trinity Shoden, Ben Bickle, the Three Rivers Maintenance and Custodial Crew, the entire office staff, counseling, and our College and Career Center, for the extra hours to make tonight look beautiful and organized. Graduates, this day has finally come. Some of you may be asking yourself the question, what was this journey for, and what did we learn from it? Have you ever heard the Matt Kearney song, Coming Home? It's from his 2015 album, Just Kids. His song reminds me of why our community loves Hidden Valley High School. It reminds me of why we live here, the beauty and the magic of this place, the scenery. If you just take a moment, people out there, graduates, take a look around. There is no setting better than the setting that you're sitting on right now. Give the setting a huge round of applause. From the state championship efforts that we're privileged to watch on this field, this track, the diamonds nearby, to the championship efforts in the classroom just 200 yards from here, the past 4 years, you have poured your heart and soul into this place you call home. The first words of this song truly set the stage for what you mean to this school. It starts, headed out down Interstate 5. My money was all spent, but I felt so alive. Alive is such a key word. Believe it or not, this year was a gift in so many ways. We, the staff of Hidden Valley High School, were gifted the opportunity to have you back. COVID took so much from you, too much, so much from us. But when school started, it was a gift that we had, that we were given to have you back. When the masks went away in March, again, another gift. But this time that gift in March came with smiles, laughs, and a few surprise mustaches or two. The heartbeat of this little school with a barn, as Amy Kablian calls it, became mighty again. This school was alive again because of you. Still, some of you may be still asking the question, what was this journey for and what did we learn from it? We learned more than ever that you are the heartbeat of this school. You are ready for life's challenges. Do not let the fear of failure or fear of comparison or fear of judgment stop you from doing what makes you great. You must leave here today, as Matt Kearney would say, to chase down a dream like we always taught you to. From this point forward, you need to trust your own voice, your own ideas, and through it all, you will find yourself on the right road. Maybe that road is Interstate 5. And maybe, just maybe, the road that takes you away from Hidden Valley High School today will be the same road that brings you back to the place that you remember. And we will open you with our arms open wide, like we have for 21 of our 50 staff members. That's right. We have 21 Mustang graduates that work at Hidden Valley. And still, some of you may be asking the question, what was this journey for and what did we learn from it? You learned everything. You are ready for the next chapter in your life. Now that you know what this journey was for and what it meant, what now? That answer is easy. Go be great, Mustangs. Go be great. But remember, this place will always be home for you. You may be graduating today, but you are forever a Mustang. Give yourselves a huge round of applause. At this time, I'd like to call up Caleb Richter to introduce our guest speaker.
All right. Our keynote speaker this evening is a Hidden Valley graduate and valedictorian from the class of 2013. She's also a former HV science teacher and an all-around great person. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. Morgan Bars.
Good evening. Let me begin by wishing you, class of 2022, and all those here who have supported, educated, and championed you, my most sincere congratulations. What a beautiful night, despite the wind, to celebrate you and your accomplishments. Graduating high school is such a special moment as it celebrates your academic achievement and is also the most universal rite of passage in our culture. A milestone that after you are considered an adult, expected to contribute to society and participate with more independence and responsibility. I am so honored to be given a few minutes to encourage you. I looked forward to being a Hidden Valley Mustang literally my whole childhood. Both my parents were Mustangs, and my siblings and I are all married to someone we met inside Hidden Valley's walls. My years as a Mustang greatly enriched my life. Returning to teach was one of the greatest privileges. One I left only for the greatest privilege of my life, building a family with my incredible husband. The last time I had the honor of standing here was almost a decade ago. And so much has transpired in my life since then. I moved away, went to college, got married, watched my siblings and friends marry, saw a bit of the world, chose a career, left a career, and had two beautiful children. Those experiences have left me with so many things I wish to tell you, pieces of advice given to me, and pieces of wisdom I discovered the hard way. So the invitation to speak to you left me with hours of prayer and meditation in deciding how to use these 3 to 5 minutes. I kept asking myself what was most central to all of that wisdom and truth I wanted to share. What one thing could I tell you that would lead you to the rest? What if applied would lead to more wisdom, and how is the best way to deliver it? Because I so deeply love science, I would like to use a biological analogy. Please don't check out at that statement. Give me a chance. Here goes. Each human has a unique DNA sequence. That sequence is primarily conserved throughout the entire species and is necessary for proper biological function. Within that code, there are small variations that create diversity within a species. Now take a minute and look at the person next to you. Actually do it. People don't do that when the speaker says so. You will see incredible diversity, but all of that is created by 0.1% difference in your genetic code. In a given sex, we are all 99.9 genetically similar. This leads me to my favorite topic, the central dogma of biology. Woohoo! Which states that DNA is transcribed into RNA, and that's translated into proteins. You see, DNA is a unique blueprint for every structure and process necessary for a given organism to survive. That blueprint must be read and copied so that cellular machinery can follow its instructions. RNA are the intermediate instructions used to produce proteins. Proteins are the cellular machinery needed to do all the work within cells. Take a second and join me in wonder and awe. We have a microscopic blueprint that has the instructions for every biological process that has and ever will occur in our bodies. From multiplying a single cell into a trillion cell organism to orchestrating every complex thought and behavior, every single structure and function in your body is dictated by 6.3 billion base pairs on a molecule that's 205 or 80 inches long, 205 centimeters or 80 inches long. Okay, I'm getting to it. Bear with me. Let me ask you, what happens when this code is mutated? Inviability, disease states, cancer, and death. If DNA is extremely mutated from the start, the embryo is often inviable. This is so common that 1 in 4 women experience this at least once in their lifetime and never even know it. Or people are born with complex disease states due to genetic mutations. DNA can become mutated throughout your life, which often results in cancer. When DNA is mutated, the instructions produced are incorrect, and the resulting proteins are misshapen, making it unable to function properly and leading to disastrous outcomes systematically. Everyone here has had some encounter with cancer, and we all understand the results. This year, our community felt the catastrophic effect of altering DNA when we lost an amazing man and longtime Mustang, Lester Crawford, to cancer. So we get the catastrophic effect of altering DNA. Here comes the analogy. There is a correct genetic code that results in this beautiful thing we call human life. When that code is altered, disease and death follow. Likewise, there is undeniable truth in this world, truth that only allows for 0.1% variation in order for people to thrive. This truth is then transcribed into values, RNA, which leads to behaviors, proteins. Here's an example. All human beings are infinitely and equally valuable. Some values or expansions of this truth is that all people should be treated with unconditional respect and kindness, or all deserve equal opportunity. Behaviors that result include listening when people talk, giving your full attention to the person in front of you, creating equal opportunities. When cultures have mutated this core truth, we end up with atrocities like the Holocaust. If you look at history, and sadly, the world today, you will see that most cultures still live with some kind of mutation of this truth that leads to cancerous practices. For example, here in the US, 1 in 10 of adults 60 plus suffer some form of elder abuse or neglect by a family member, according to the National Council on Aging. Or in many parts of India, baby girls are boiled alive or left on the street to die because daughters are expensive and less valuable, and the families are deeply impoverished. When the core truth of human value is mutated, we are left with what you could very easily call cancerous outcomes. One of the most dangerous mutations in our current culture is that living out your own truth is of supreme importance. Like every other person here, I want you to lead lives of meaning, purpose, connection, and fulfillment. Seeking your own truth will not lead you to a life of meaning, purpose, connection, and fulfillment. Seeking the truth and living in line with that will lead to a life of meaning, purpose, connection, and fulfillment. Go find someone who is 60 plus and has led a life marked by these four things. Ask them about truth and really listen. Our culture believes truth is relative, and individual truth and self-expression are most important. The 0.1% of your DNA that makes you look different is of very little biological importance. The same is true of truths that really should be individual. Truth likes the best climate, the best candy, truck brand, hobbies, etc. The truths that guide life are universal. And the thought that it is otherwise is a mutated truth that will lead you to intermediate falsehoods and destructive behaviors that do not build lives of meaning, purpose, connection, and fulfillment. You may be sitting there saying, okay, Morgan, well, why don't you tell us the truth? And honestly, I would love to sit down with you and talk about capital T truth. If you want to, then look me up on social media. I have Facebook, which I know you don't. I'm old. But I also have Instagram. Or my cell number, you all have your cell phone, I'm sure, is 541-660-6276. Let's get coffee. But we don't really find truths that we live by listening to someone talk in a microphone. No, we have to actively participate. We have to seek truth and work it out. That is your most important work in the next 5 years. Don't waste these next few years enjoying your newfound independence. Have fun, but invest your time in seeking truth. Discern the mutated truths of our culture and seek to build a life that lives by them, by truths that lead to life-giving behaviors. I wouldn't be a science fanatic if I didn't make a biological analogy, and I wouldn't be a teacher at heart if I didn't give you a homework assignment. Or if the word homework makes you immediately check out or cry, call it a response. I would like you to go home and write a paragraph you hope to be true at the end of your life. They say begin with the end in mind. So step into your adult life and begin to intentionally craft your legacy. Write a sentence, a paragraph, a speech you hope will be true when people get up to speak at your memorial service. Then, as you seek truth and determine the resulting life-giving values and behaviors, make your memorial speech line up with those. You can use that speech to check that you are living well. You can use it to help you make big decisions. This has been greatly helpful for me. Any good assignment is accompanied by an example. So here is the paragraph I hope currently will be true at my memorial. Morgan Barrs loved Jesus. Those who know her know that she valued people above all else as image bearers of God. This could be seen in the way that she loved her husband, children, family, friends, and community. Morgan was a local girl who lived in Grants Pass her whole life and in each season invested in her community. She was loving, generous, and kind. She always had time to talk or share a meal. Mrs. Barrs loved to be outside and with people, especially if there was good food involved. Morgan loved to laugh, have passionate discussions, and sit in awe of nature. She will be dearly missed by her children, grandchildren, and many dear friends. Ladies and gentlemen, I implore you to use these next 5 years wisely. Don't extend your adolescence or abuse your independence. Get to work, seek truth, capital T truth, that when amplified out leads to the creation and protection of life. Contribute to your community, love well, and live intentionally. Congratulations, class of 2022.
This might be the largest interview committee of all time, but I think, Morgan, you're hired again, right? All right. Before I invite our valedictorians and salutatorian to the stage to address the graduating class of 2022, I would like to direct you and your attention to the program that recognizes the academic honors that many of our graduates are displaying this evening. We have valedictorians, salutatorian, honors diploma, National Honor Society, FBLA, student leadership, music, FFA, and CTE. Each honor recognized tonight is denoted in the program with a symbol, and each graduate being honored tonight has a series of colored cords, cowls, and stoles. This is a time-honored tradition to recognize the tremendous academic achievements of each graduating class. The class of 2022 is no exception. Please give them a huge round of applause for everything they've accomplished. I wish Blake was saying this part, because Blake has already been hired as our MC for basketball games forever, and Blake and I have already talked about that. Where are you, Blake? There you are. So don't forget, you're hooked. But at this time, I would like to call our valedictorians and salutatorian to the stage. Please give a warm welcome to Leah Beachy, Maria Cross, Ronan Hodge, and Morgan Stever.
Thank you, Mr. Croson. And good evening to the class of 2022. After a unique 4 years as Mustangs, we finally made it. It's simultaneously sad and exciting to say that we'll be on to live our own lives after this, some moving across the country and others staying in Oregon, all in the pursuit of our passions. The moments we have all shared together as classmates will live on in our memories forever. I remember preschool, where the two memories that truly stick out are the cupcake parties with classmates, as well as kicking over Isaac Hill's block towers for our entertainment before our daily nap. Then to elementary school, where the social hierarchy was determined by your athleticism in the game of wall ball at Jerome Prairie and tetherball at Madrona. Now, I hope we can all agree that middle school was a wild blend of puerile behavior and the most awkward school dances a human can witness. I won't go any further than that for legal reasons. Also, Ms. Towns, remember to round my grade up because I used that vocab word. Coming into freshman year, we finally felt we had made it to the big leagues. Well, that went by. And then sophomore year came, and wham. From our record-breaking state championship teams from many of our athletic programs, go Cats, to having completed calculus in 3 months, the adversity that COVID posed on everything, especially education, was immeasurable. I never thought I could not only remain in PJs from head to toe till 2 p.m., but push through the elegance and dignified sound of concert band rehearsal on Google Meet.
Well, while we can fondly reminisce on aspects of these last 4 years, our past accomplishments, the memories we have made, the championships we have won, and the friendships we have built, our road to graduation was not without its obstacles. COVID hit us like a brick wall. No more classes, no more sports, no more dances. It was hard on everyone, parents, teachers, and students alike. The effect COVID had on our education, mental health, and our high school experience was astronomical. Yet we sit here today together, not virtually or 6 feet apart or concealed by masks, but actually together. After 2 years of social distancing and virtual learning, this is certainly a breath of fresh air. We, the class of 2022, had a surreal high school experience. The so-called extended spring break in sophomore year developed into a virtual junior year, pitting us against the indomitable force of edgenuity, a learning tool that spurred the vice of procrastination in many. Even when we were physically back in school, masked and 6 feet apart, we struggled. Whether in the classroom, on the field, or still persevering through online learning, everything was 10 times harder. Despite it all of the obstacles in our path, we as a class prevailed. We found ways to adapt, to learn, to stay connected, to take care of each other, and to succeed. We are walking across this stage today as high school graduates, and we have set a precedent of determination for those who come after us.
Oh, geez. The next chapter of our lives will behold many uncertainties and triumphs. Steve Marboli once said, "This is your life, your story, your book. Let today be the day you no longer let anyone else write it, nor apologize for the edits you make." Some of us are off to college, joining the military, or going to trade school. Some of us will be farmers or artists. Others will become experts in crypto and the stock market. But one thing connects us all. That commonality is that we are all Hidden Valley Mustangs. We all live orange, and we all bleed blue, and every morning we drive over the same stupid yellow speed bumps to and from school. After leaving those front gates one last time, we as a senior class want to thank you, Hidden Valley. You will always have a special place in our hearts. The experiences we have had here will help us guide us wherever we go next. Although our classmates will travel all across the world, one thing will keep us connected. The small, beautiful community we have built here in Murphy these last 4 years is something we cannot just forget about. It will keep every single one of us connected, not just through in-person interactions and social media, but in our hearts just as much. As the great sage, street poet, and philosopher Drizzy Drake once said, "Class of 2022, we started from the bottom, now the whole team here."
But before we end this speech and get the party started, we, along with the class of 2022, would like to express our gratitude to all of those in our lives that were instrumental in everything leading up to this moment. First of all, thank you to the teachers, coaches, and staff members who poured so much into us and put up with all our nonsense. And a big shout out.
Yeah!
And a big shout out to the to the administration team for letting us graduate somehow. All of you are the heart and soul of Hidden Valley, and we thank you for your investment in us. To all of you out there, family and friends, we cannot overstate our appreciation for what you have done for us. Thank you, grandparents. Aunts, uncles, cousins, really anyone who sent money in our birthday cards. It meant a lot. Thank you to older siblings for modeling how it's done and to younger ones for teaching anger management skills. Parents and guardians, you saw us through these last 18 years, and whether we'd like to admit it or not, you were right about 99% of the things you warned us of. As you scream at the top of your lungs when your kid walks across the stage, know that, as Abraham Lincoln once said, all that we are or hope to be, we owe to our parents. And also, we respect you immensely for making it through high school without the internet. So, class of 2022, we made it. Today is a day of relief and celebration. Congratulations on a job well done. Let's go be great. Thank you.
I mean, I've heard of long shots in horse racing, but of all the students here to drop that bomb, Leah Beachy was not on the card. And the cool part is she gets to tell that story 15 years from now to her kids. It's going to be awesome. Way to go, Leah. Leah, do you want to do the rest of this? Any? No? Friends, family, and graduates, the time has finally arrived to begin announcing the names of the graduating class of 2022. Prepare yourselves. I am honored to invite to the stage the first reader for tonight's ceremony, Mrs. Sandra Wright.
Good evening. It is my privilege to be able to read names, and I get the greatest privilege of starting off with my son, Connor James Wright. Our next graduate is Michaela Sue Johnson. Our next graduate is the one, the only, Miss Leah Beachy. Our next graduate is Miss Maria Cross. Our next graduate is Mr. Morgan Stever. Our next graduate is Mr. Caleb Richter. Our next graduate is Mr. Ronan Hodge. Our next graduate is Mr. Noah Stone. Our next graduate is Miss Cheyenne Smith. Our next graduate is Miss Hannah Groh. Our next teacher presenter is Miss Laurelyn Towns.
I'm pleased to announce my first name is Lauren Nicole Raybon. Eduardo Strandrini. Mr. Nolan Daniel Kennedy.
Wow.
That was pretty amazing. Miss Taya Adele Mendoza.
No dance for him?
No.
Miss Hannah Marie Bennett.
Thank you.
Miss Chloe Daniel Grace Larson. Miss Kylie Lynn Douglas. Miss Noelle Lowry. Miss Abigail Desiree Bogman. Miss Willow May Roberts. The next presenter is Mr. Ben Bickle.
Use this, if this is flapping around.
Good evening. I have the unique privilege of reading off the following names for the 2022 graduates. Miss Britannica Bennett. Miss Abigail Knight. Miss Lexi Hill. Miss Lily Emmons. Miss Lori Yates. Miss Rita Cauldron.
Thank you.
Miss Kira Wallace. Miss Trinity Capaldo. Up next, Mr. Connor Bogard. Miss Lilia Bilbando. Our next presenter is Miss Teresa D'Souza.
Good evening. I have the honor of presenting our next graduate, Abigail Sutton. Next is Erica Cottrell. Our next graduate is Layla Bowen. Next is Mr. Jacob Daniel Cook. Next is Jessavana Aline DeMarco. Next is Alexis Gonzalez. Next is Frankie Gilbert Vasquez. Our next graduate is Hunter Kraus. Next graduate is Jacob John Hughes.
Thank you.
And next is Emma Catania. Our next presenter is Heidi Morris.
Jonathan Wright. Logan Regal. Timothy Scott Reardon. Reed Howerton. Nope. Soren Joseph Emmons. Aiden Joseph Shear. Derek Joseph Blacksmith. Congratulations, Derek. Cooper John Marchand. Congratulations, Cooper. Brandon Young. Troy Johnson. Presenting next, the inimitable Jenny Groover.
good evening. So it's my honor and pleasure for the very last time after 27 years to read the following graduates. Jade Klipfel. Woo! All right. Guy Mead. Kadeen Servak. Quade Kroom. Dakota Levitt. Demas Linares. Audrey Farron. Alyssa Kelly. Aiden Moon Reed.
Amazing.
Connor Daly.
Thank you, Ms. Groover.
And now, Mr. Delgado.
It is my pleasure to introduce the following Hidden Valley graduates. Forrest Applegate. James Vale Watson. Ryan Becker. William Hellman.
I don't know if I can give you a hug, Will. I gotta get up.
Aramis Cook Best. Wearing our Eagle Scout cord, Dakota Brayman. Chris Mills Price. Sean Barnes. Sailor Beck. Marissa Beck. And now next, we have Mr. Ethan Bass.
It is my honor to announce these next 10 graduates.
Our first one, Mr. Blake Josiah Ho'omanawanui Zay. Mr. Nate Mark Vidlak. Mr. Spencer Paul Fisk. Mr. Theo Bergman. Mr. Tristan Matthews. Mr. William Simmons. Mr. Isaac Wayne Hill. Mr. Luke Matthew. Mr. Bailey Hafley. Mr. Miles Davis. Announcing our next graduates is Mr. John Johal.
So I get the privilege of announcing the next names. First up, Casey Morton. You! Casey Morton? That's... Next is Esmel Guerrero. Next is Devin Flores. Next is Bailey Sturgis. Next is Christopher Woods. Next is Ashton Marchington. Next is Savannah McGuire.
Aw, thank you.
Next is Emma Cooper.
I'm not going to cry. Congratulations.
Next is Owen Smith. And lastly is Joshua Disney.
Our next announcer is Trinity Shoden.
I have the honor of presenting the following students with the diplomas. Miss Audrey Elizabeth Cook. Chloe Elizabeth Zimmerman. Logan James Simons.
I love you.
Jackson West Gilbert. Tamia Nicole Harmon. Kaylin Faith Gonzalez. Mr. Gama Duenas. The next presenter is Ms. Crystal Welch.
Ms. Jesslyn Guiley. Ms. Tanner Christensen. Ms. Delaney Skinner.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
Ms. Hope Foster. Mr. Gabe Chavez.
Thank you.
Miss Olivia McCurdy. Miss Kaylee Schrader. Miss Crystal Madras Delgado. And now, Mr. Keith Haley.
It's my pleasure to introduce the following graduates: Jesse Aaron Musto. Shane Walker Brosmore.
Yes, sir.
Ethan Dustin Catania. Logan Anthony Dove. Lucas Serrano. James Blanton.
Thank you very much.
Skylar Ray Willie. Taryn Grace Powers.
Thank you.
Carlin Nielsen. And Hannah Reyes. Next presenter, Mr. Adam Sable.
Very pleased tonight to honor and respect a young man from the class of 2022 that is not here tonight to receive his diploma, but we are very honored and glad that his mother is here to receive it for him. So please, Sarah, come forward and receive an honorary diploma for your son, Mason Keene. Okay, other graduates tonight, we have Alisana Noga. Caitlin O'Neill. Chance Dickinson. Clark Wettengel. Johanna DeVos.
Thank you.
Charlize Sorensen.
Now, if there was betting, I would have bet those two would have taken the longest at the pictures for sure. Graduates, on behalf of the Three Rivers School District board members, Superintendent Dave Valenzuela, Hidden Valley faculty, these students before you have met all the graduation requirements of the Three Rivers School District and the state of Oregon. They have earned the right to be granted their diplomas. At this time, it is now my privilege to present to you the graduating class of 2022. Please stand. Please move your tassels from right to left. And graduates, at this time, please toss your caps. Congratulations. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for attending our graduation ceremony. Please join us in the commons for cookies, photos, and the seniors will pick up. diplomas up in the comments. Thank you. Like you always taught me to. But the evergreens and caffeine still remind me of you.